But okay, let's go to some questions.
Okay. Time for some Bring It On. This is from Lynn Pat, who says, my husband and I are separated. He continues to have sex with another woman. He says God forgives each time he has sex. But if you're not repentant enough to stop, does God keep forgiving this? Obviously, he's not sorry or he would stop. How do you see Hebrews 10:26 that says, for if we sin willfully after we've received the knowledge of the truth, there no longer remains a sacrifice for sins?
Well, I tell you what, if I were that buddy, he's skating on mighty thin ice, and he's going to go to hell, and the devils are going to be taunting him. He's going to say, but you don't understand. I had a get-out-of-jail-free card, and they say, no, you didn't. I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. You can't presume on the goodness of the Lord like that. And I don't understand you're separated. Why don't you get divorced? I mean, you're separated. And he's committing serial adultery, living with another woman. I don't understand. I can't understand these relationships that take place. But
yeah,
sooner or later, I mean, you have grounds, biblical grounds, to get on with your life. And, you know, you're still worrying about him committing sin. What you need to do is pray for him and, you know, love him as you would any human being. But get on with your life and let him live his life and you live yours, rather than looking for stuff in the Bible to show why he's wrong. I mean, you don't need that. You know, get on with your life and, you know, he's cut the cords of that relationship, and you have biblical grounds, according to the Jesus, to get a divorce, get remarried, get on with your life. So I'd suggest you do it.
Okay, this is Rob, who says, Pat, I'm struggling so hard with my faith these days. I feel so distant from God, and no matter what I try, I feel like I'm getting further away from him. I have severe depression and daily pain from acute colitis. I think of ending my life daily, yet when I turn to God, all I feel is a great emptiness. And when I pray, awful thoughts run through my mind, blocking the prayer. What am I doing wrong? I need help.
Well, I don't think you are doing anything wrong, but I think something inside of you is wrong. Colitis is caused by extreme tension and stress, and you've got something going on that is causing your body to rebel against you, and it's trying to recover. I really think you need to have a complete physical. You need to understand the whole pathology of what's going on in your life, and you need to get that physical stuff fixed. As long as you've got that condition, then your mind isn't, it doesn't have enough stability to handle the pressure that you've got. So we just did a piece on stress, and I think the stress is causing the colitis. The colitis, in turn, is causing you to feel spiritually bankrupted. So you can go back the other way. Get before the Lord and just talk to him, you know, talk to God, and like he's your friend, and say, look, God, I've got this problem, help me. And then I do recommend, though, that you go to somebody who is skilled in advanced medicine and see what you can find out about the problems you have.
Yeah, he mentioned severe depression, and that also is an imbalance in your body. So
I think it's caused by physiological forces, and you need maybe some medication on it. You need to figure your diet and exercise and all that stuff that's causing it. You may have vitamin deficiency. There's so many things, but get to somebody who can help you. All right.
This is Curtis, who says, I was baptized years ago and received the Holy Spirit then. Between then and now, I strayed, but never lost my belief in God and Jesus. God does work in my life now, but somehow I feel that the Spirit is not the same as it was before. Should I get baptized to receive the Holy Spirit again? Please answer this for me.
No, you've done what you need to do. You know, there's a guy named David, and he was king, and the time had come when kings are supposed to go off to war, and he stayed at home in the palace. Then he's looking down at the rooftop of a lady. She's taking a bath. Her name is Bathsheba. She's gorgeous, and he's out there. And so he's got all these women. He's got all these wives. He's got concubines. He's got all the sex he can handle, but he sees one more. And so he says, well, you bring her over to me. And so here she comes, and he's king, and she has to do what he tells her to do, and so they have sex together, and she gets pregnant, and then she has a baby. And now he goes and tries to kill one of the special members of his elite guard. Uriah the Hittite just wasn't some soldier out there. He was a member of the 30, the really august group. And so he takes him up there and tries to get him to go home, sleep with his wife, and he says, I'm not going to do it. And so he sends him back to the battle with orders to be put in the front of the troops and get killed. So David commits adultery, tries to cover it up, has the innocent person murdered, and then he goes before God. Now, that's about as bad as you can get in it. And so you read the Bible, it says, restore unto me the joy of my salvation, and get this, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. So despite everything David had done, the Holy Spirit was still there. But the joy of his salvation had gone. So what you do is confess your sin, you come to the Lord, and but you don't have to go back and say, I want the Holy Spirit again, because if you have the gifts and calling of God are without repentance. So in your life, spend time, take it easy, and talk to the Lord and let Him restore what's there. And He'll do it because He loves you. That's all the time we've got. Thanks for those questions. Some pretty tough questions today, but we'll do the best we can. Well, today's Power Minute is from Psalm 86. Quote, for you, Lord, are good and ready to forgive and abundant in mercy to all those who call upon you.